out there, and not forgetting the bent-friendly viewers either. I hope you're enjoying tonight's third prisoner invasion of Squeal. But for now, the weather. It'll be fine tonight and a few showers tomorrow, but a chance of a late thunderstorm. It'll be a humid day with fresh to strong northeast to northerly winds, and a top temperature of 31 degrees. Wednesday will be mainly fine and 30 degrees. Thursday will be fine and 28 degrees. With Friday, fine and hot 35 degrees. Well, that's it from this weather girl for now, and we'll see you again shortly. Enjoy.
It's not that gay and lesbian Ben TV again. You know I've got a bad ticker.
Oh, shut up, Dizzy. This week they've got almost as many people as a cast of Prisoner.
Oh, dear. That was our special. Oh. That was lovely, Miss Vic and our special EP, Stephen, doing their little Prisoner tribute from last week. How'd you find that?
Oh, breathtaking. Yeah. I'm lost for words.
Got my teeth in this week.
Now, there's a couple of things before we go on. Joy, you've probably noticed that Joy has gone, but she will be back. She's gone to get our special guest.
Ooh. She's bringing up the royal carriage.
That's right. Ooh. Now, be quiet, everyone. Don't give it away. And also, we must say, we've forgotten to do this, we must say thank you to Grundy's for providing us with the footage. So thank you, Grundy's. Love your work. Love your work.
And actually, Grundy's, I might say too, Grundy's have pitched in with four return airfares from Sydney to bring down four of the cast members.
Fantastic. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. There you go.
We asked them for 20, but they're going
to April 20. Yeah.
And that can I say that's Judith McGrath.
Oh, yes.
Oh, God, she knows. Andy Anderssen, Les Diamond coming down, Peter Tapano, Tracy Mann. And there's going to be lots of other people there. Tell you who's going to be there. Siggy Thornton and Terry Armstrong.
Siggy Thornton? Oh, my God.
They're going to be there. Lots of Neighbours people are going to be there. Not only Ian Smith, but not only Prisoner people.
Anyone in the Australian film industry.
Anyway,
Patterson's going to be there.
Now we're going to get a bit serious for a moment. Stephanie Moore is with us from Positive Women. You are the coordinator of Positive Women.
That's right.
Yes,
that's
right. So, and this is, yeah, you're, well, Positive Women is the reason this whole shebang is happening, really, isn't it?
That's right.
So, Positive Women, you don't really hear much about Positive Women in the media, gay or mainstream.
Otherwise, yes. No, you don't. I mean, I think that's, a lot of people find that too. Quite amazing that there are women around with HIV/AIDS. So, you know, we actually, within the gay community, we've got quite a small profile. And one of the good things about the Prisoner fundraiser, and also another event that we're involved in, is that we're going to be raising the profile of these women to let the people know that, you know, women do get HIV/AIDS, that there is, needs to be community awareness, there needs to be education, and we also need support, you know.
And it's a different kind of support.
Yeah, I mean, our women, most half the women have got kids.
Exactly.
Yeah. Maybe single parents.
So you need like...
Yeah. Also, too, Stephanie, I would think that the problem with a woman who's HIV/AIDS is the... Do you tell the community?
Yeah.
When you've got children, when you've perhaps got a partner...
That's right, Annie.
Who is in a high-flying job? Yeah. Do you tell the school?
No. Yeah. Those are the issues for the women. I mean, within the gay community, there's sort of a community within a community. Mm. But for our women, we're often very isolated and also on their own, maybe, or maybe with a partner. But you know, if they tell the, you know, if they tell the school, or if their kids get sort of then stigmatised or discriminated against, you know.
Does that happen?
It has happened. Yeah.
Well, Alicia was on last week, and she was still in school, I think, when her mother was diagnosed HIV positive. And she said it was good in the sense that her actual school, they got together an education program for the kids in the school.
Which was great.
It was approached in a positive way, because that was my concern for her last week. I said, did you Because not that it matters how you get HIV, exactly. But her mother got it through transfusion.
That's right. Mm.
But there is a stigma involved having HIV, and therefore kids also suffer.
And kids get cruel.
And that's also why the women don't want to go out, and you know they're not as sort of open about their status as some of the other groups are. Yeah. So, you know, the Positive Women organisation is a really good support for them, where they can come and meet with other women to talk about the issues that are relevant to women, you know, I mean, gynecological issues, kids.
It's good to meet someone who's got the same problems,
exactly.
Isn't it?
Yeah. Exactly. So and get that support and not feel, you know, so isolated or so discriminated against or ashamed, embarrassed,
the thing that's
guilty.
Too, is that it's actually not just for positive women themselves, it's for positive women and their
family and their friends.
So it's a support group for the partners and the kids within that as well, which is really, really expensive because the focal point of our conversation last week, and you said it's not. And it was Alicia as well that said it, it's not people dying of HIV.
It's
the people living with it that we've got to.
And that's one of the things that we're looking at addressing, you know, how do people live with AIDS? You know, what is it that people want to do that makes the quality of life? It's about the quality of life.
Well, that's what your slogan is, isn't it?
You know, and that slogan came about as a result of, we've got a triathlon team, which is also on tomorrow, down at Elwood, 7:45, if people want to get up early.
Is that Sunday? Yes, sorry. That's okay.
Thank you to everyone that went.
It was a huge success.
Yeah, big turnout. Should have been there.
Yeah. And it was a result of and they came up with that slogan: "Positive women living life." You know,
as
opposed to just dying from the disease, but living.
And also, too, Stephanie, I found with helping to coordinate the prisoner party, which of course is an AIDS fundraiser.
Yep.
That's really the only reason we're doing it.
Yeah.
The reunion and a whole lot of us getting together and having a good time is really secondary to us getting together and raising money for AIDS.
Yeah.
And I forgot what I was going to say now. Oh yes, do you find that HIV/AIDS now is not in advertising parlance sexy anymore?
Yeah.
It's like been there, done that. What are they still whinging about, you know?
Yeah. But
and I'm finding that very difficult to cope with.
It's a hard one. It's like passe or something.
Now
We just have to go to Sue and Tabitha for some community news
and a giveaway
And what a giveaway it is too. What are we going to do, Tabby? We've got fans. We've got news everywhere. I'll just read this one out. This is I've dropped the thing. Got to read that for a second while I re-establish myself.
I wouldn't actually like to read out Margaret. It's far more important. Those who are out there, you're feeling isolated, you need advance AIDS information. Call. Is that the gamma line?
Gamma. Yes.
Gamma. As in gummy, but with an A. So it's gamma line. 0398990059 or 1-800-807-6600. I sound like I'm doing a telephone.
I was going to say thank you very much to the bisexual man.
And if there's any like confused Turkish or Greek boys, you can get my number, care of SQUEAL, okay? I'll help you. I'll confuse you any which way I know how. That's what I'm here for. I do community services.
I think that just about let's do our sponsorship things.
Well, can we do our giveaway, Susan?
Let's do the giveaway then.
It's a very exciting giveaway. Thank you, Susan. Together again for the very first time. It's a prisoner giveaway, that's right, that's what it is. Someone has donated a lovely ticket. Do you know who donated it? Yes, that was donated by one of the union officials at MEAA. So he's donated this ticket. So all you need to do is ring up and answer a very simple question. That was, how was B. Smith killed in the Prisoner series? Answer that. First one through, he gets the question correct. Of course, the question was again. How did B. Smith die? It was a very tragic night at my house. I know I was crying. My mum came out with a hot Milo and a soggy bicky. So you think that's who Rich has got the number for you?
I do have the number here. It is 966-35902. You can all contact us on the email.
No, they've got to phone it through, Sue.
What if they want to email?
I don't care, they're not allowed
to. We're not emailing them.
Only use the internet, of course, to look up Days of the Lions website.
Oh, stop it, we're not doing that.
Okay, we're going to the footage now. We've got some special footage. Thank you, thank you.
We've
got some footage.
A couple of years younger, I wouldn't mind a slice myself.
Bastard.
The police will be here soon. Will you be okay?
Killed him. I didn't mean to.
I know. It was self-defense, Mum. Kay and I'll back you up on that.
He said some terrible things, Alan.
It's all right. It'll be okay, Mum.
I'll do this.
Oh! Whoa. Okay.
Whoa. Now, there was some pretty groovy footage of you there, eh?
Yeah, how slim and young and dark-haired was I. Now, this is one of the things in the auction that you'll get on the night. Morrie Fields, the beautiful, gorgeous late Morrie Fields.
Yes.
His son, Marty, is the MC for the night. There he is, strangling Maggie Kirkpatrick. And Val Gillet, of course, his wife, she's there. And she's actually going to be singing, too, on the night.
I'm
trying to get rid of the flair there. But, of course, all of this is to do with raising money for
positive women
at the Bouverie Street. You can see the badge, and the badge is also up for auction. There you go.
It was Len Murphy,
that's
right. Oh, you're good.
I want you at my table on a trivia night.
Tabby has actually got the phone number that people need to call for positive women.
Yes, if you'd like more information in positive women in Victoria, of course, telephone number 03, you should know that because you're in Victoria, 92766918. And the address is, P.O. Box 222, Cohan, Victoria 3181.
There you go.
So, for any information, please feel free to give them a call. They'll be only too happy to help.
And also, Stephanie, Alfred Hospital.
Yep.
If people didn't have their pens and papers, Alfred Hospital, just ask for positive women.
That's right. Yep. That's right. And
you respond, if you'd like to send any mail at all to the fantastic Squeal, this might be a lovely letter to myself, Tabitha, all the lovely boys up here. Please send them to care of Bent TV, PO Box 2248. Stop blowing my ear. Thank you. Paran 3181. Thank you very much.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Now, next up, we're going to go for a break, but just remember, we've got that special guest. So,
coming up.
Make your coffee, make your tea.
And only 5 days to the Prince.
5 days.
Tickets on the night.
That's right. We need to help positive women and give positive women a call and help them, support them in practical ways.
If you can't come, send a donation via MEAA, the union.
Here we go. Come back.
On the knowledge of the game in the past, the others much younger than yourself, brothers and sisters who were just like yourself, 'cause that cycle.